乾杯。
Hello, hello, good afternoon.
Hello,
hello, hello. Konnichiwa. No. Hello.
Konnichiwa.
Konnichiwa. I know a little bit of Japanese, not too much, but I know hello and goodbye and how are you and all that.
How are you?
I'm fine, dear. I am Richard. I work for My London Cafe Art. I'm a homeless artist on the streets of London. I've been on the streets for 4 years.
How long have you been selling these calendars?
I have been selling this calendar in London for the past 4 years. And I arrived in London maybe 2016, at the beginning of 2016, so it's almost 4 years. I was then asked if I would like to sell this calendar. Before I was homeless, I used to be a salesman. Mm. So I said, yes, okay. So I've been involved with selling the calendar. Mm. And homelessness is just everywhere now, especially in London. It's a really bad problem. But this is a great way of raising money, making money to distribute to the homeless.
How often do you sell these calendars?
From September through to February, so 5 months. Usually it's October, but we started selling it earlier just to sell this calendar because I don't like catching buses. I like keeping fit. I'm 60 years old next year. 60 years old.
So where do you sleep at?
I sleep on a bench in St Pancras Station in the centre of London. I've been sleeping on that for at least 2 years, but because I'm an artist, I spend a lot of time drawing in the station, and the security guards know me, so they don't give me any trouble. They just let me stay there. The only thing is, you can't sleep on the floor. You have to sleep sitting up. I'm quite rare. Not many people like me who can do that, but I can do it, and they just leave me alone. So I've got a roof over my head. It's quite warm. It's secure. It's not dangerous because it's in the station. The security cameras everywhere, but obviously I don't have my own bed. But hopefully next year I'll have my own bed, because I don't want to carry on doing this forever, being on the streets. I've been homeless on and off for 15 years in many cities in England, Scotland and Wales, including Glasgow. And I've written a book which will be published, but I'm not prepared to say anything about it. It's about my 59 years on this planet. And I met the publisher here 3 years ago. And she said, if you can write this book, I will publish it. So for 3 years, I've been trying to write a book while selling a calendar, doing my artwork, and everything else.
How much is this?
£10.99. And I will sign every copy that I sell. And that's my little thing there. That's my photograph. That's my write-up. That talks about the film I'm doing. It talks about the book I'm doing.
So every time you sell these calendars, how much do you get?
I get £5, and the rest of it goes to Cafe Art, who redistribute the money to the homeless. But they have to pay me something for coming out here and selling, because I've been selling from 10 o'clock till 5 o'clock. It's quite cold here today. It's very breezy.
Yeah.
And sometimes you're just standing here for hours, not selling anything, and it can get a bit boring and a bit cold. And quite difficult. I don't make a living out of it, but I make decent money. I make decent money.
May I support you by getting this?
Yes, I will happily sell this to you. You can either have a large one, or we have a desktop calendar as well. Whether you want a small one or a large one, I will sign it to you.
So probably I'm gonna get that one. So please sign up for that one.
So I'll sign this for you. Okay. Oops. Oh, don't worry about it. Don't worry about it. Filming yourself.
Yeah.
All right. Can I write your name in it? Your name is?
Kanon.
K-A-N-O-N. K-A-N-O-N. Kanon.
Yes,
oh, that's never heard of that before. I'll put the Happy New Year, wherever you're spending it, 2020. And I'll put best wishes from me, Richard. There
Richard.
We go.
Richard!
And I'll give you a little triangly thing and another... smiley face. Bless your heart.
Thank you.
You're welcome.
May I pay by card?
Yes, you may indeed. I hope the card machine is working. It should be. I'll just put that on there. They only taught me how to use this last week, but it's quite simple. All right.
No.
So Kanon, just press that or tap it. Hang on.
Yeah.
Tap it. Just tap it.
Yeah.
Yep. Reading card.
Yay.
And I have to write you in my book. These are the ones I've sold today. I've sold about 13 today. So card goes on there like that. So we have to keep a record of what we're doing. I've sold 12. Yeah, which is it's okay. I usually sell better than that, but we're in a a difficult place here because there's an art thing going on around the corner.
Yes.
I'm just going to have a cup of tea.
Yeah, please, please.
All right, okay. Ah, kanpai.
Kanpai. What do you know words?
Yeah, I do. No, that just came out of the blue. I don't know why I knew that. I just felt that was the right word.
Is it
right?
It's the right word.
Kanpai.
Kanpai. How did you know one?
I just guessed. No.
It cannot be happened by
guessing. I think my goddaughter told me that word. Kanpai.
And I
remembered it because I know it's similar in Korean. I think it's konbei or something.
Oh.
So it's very similar, but kanpai, I remember it.
Do you meet your daughter often?
Goddaughter. She lives in Wales about three or four times a year, and I see her times a year.
Does she visit you or
no,
you go there?
No, never in London. I always go to see her. I'm her godfather. I'm not a relation. I'm not her father. I have no children.
Do you have any siblings?
No, I'm the only child. I'm from the north of England in Yorkshire. I do have family up there, but I haven't seen any of them since about 12 years ago. My mother died in 2008, and I kind of left. I was what we call in Britain the black sheep. I'm completely different from everybody else in my family. I'm the only creative person, and eventually I just kind of left. And but I've travelled around the world. I've done a lot of things, and I'm happy. For the first time in my life, I found happiness. I'm going to try to be happy in comfort. I'm going to try to have a bed. Somewhere I can cook, somewhere I can keep private instead of having to just walk around London all the time and all the pollution and all the everything else, because it's quite stressful. I've had many years of this, but at least I have a job where I can earn money, getting cups of tea and, you know, having a smile on my face. That's good.
What is the good moment when being on the street?
I don't beg. I've never begged. I don't receive money. I don't receive food, but I do go to, we call them food banks, so about two or three times a day I go to places where they serve food with many homeless people. And a lot of people in London, they don't go short of food, they don't go short of clothes. We have places where we can go for to eat and to get a shower and to have toiletries. We have places where we can get what we need. The reason there's a lot of homeless people in London is because the welfare system in London is pretty generous, and so people come here because they know they're going to be looked after. And that's why we've got so many homeless people in this country who just decide to do nothing with their lives. I think that's very sad. I'm not like that. I try to do something with my life, hence this calendar, hence my artwork.
That's good. But,
you know, I feel in a happy place at the moment, but it can get better, and I just hope that, you know, things 2020 will be good. I'm positive and hopeful, and thanks for meeting you.
What's your dream?
My dream is to I don't know. I don't know what my dream is. Maybe to die with people knowing that I made at least one good film. And I'm trying to get a film done, and hopefully I will. And if it gets onto the screen, I'm not worried about how much money it makes. It might make nothing, but if people at least see something that I have been responsible for, then I will be happy. I will still live a very, very simple life, because money means nothing. Possessions mean nothing. I've had no possessions for many years, so they mean nothing to me now. And I've kept nothing because you can't take it with you. What can you do with it? So, you know.
What's the life for you?
What is life for me? There is a Japanese author. Can I just have I brought it with me? Just a minute. Can you just hang on a minute?
Yeah.
And I think she said sometimes you have to travel a long way to see what's right in front of you. I've done that, and I have seen what's in front of me. And now I'm not falling over things. I'm seeing with clarity and purpose after a life of struggle. My message is: be true to yourself. Try to do what's in your heart, rather than do what people tell you. I'm not saying be an anarchist or anything. I'm just saying if you feel you've got something to say, then say it, but try not to upset people. Just go your own way. Don't be afraid of it. If you are prepared to make an effort and to do something honestly and sincerely, then eventually you will get some divine good fortune, and I've had it over the last two or three years. Thank you, darling. Okay.
Thank you.
I think you've got enough for that, haven't you? You're doing well.
It was so nice to see you, and probably I'm going to miss you.
Are you going back to Japan?
No.
Or do you live here?
I have to live here. I've been here for 2 years, so probably I may have a chance to see you again.
Well, I'm here every Thursday, every Friday, here till February. And one day I'll have to look at you, whatever you've edited for YouTube. Okay, sayonara.
Thank you.
You're welcome. All right.
Okay.
All right then.
Thank you.
Okay. Okay, take care.
Thank you. Bye.
Bye-bye. Bye.
Yeah.